Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Professor Julius Manyala, and my colleague here is called Kenneth Rono, is in charge of this hatchery. Now, this hatchery is producing tilapia fingerlings, which we give to farmers for grow out in cages, or those who have ponds can grow them in the ponds. We have males in one tank and females in another tank. The reason why we separate them is because they produce very fast if you leave them, and you'll have too much fish that cannot also grow. So we separate them and breed them in one of the tanks. Then we take the eggs, which we incubate, like you do the chicken, and then we get the fingerlings, or the small fish, which we give to farmers to grow. Now, before we give farmers, we change the sex of this fish by giving them a special feed so that they are all males. And the reason why we do this is because the males grow faster than the females. They are also resistant to diseases, and they don't spend much energy in reproducing. And that is why it is more preferred. Now, we feed them with a floating feed, and this floating feed, we do it because tilapia feeds on the surface, unlike the catfish, which feeds at the bottom. Now, these tanks, we have to supply that with water, and the water is a flow-through system. So if you look at the center, you will see a pipe. When we add the water, we put an overflow there, and all the water that is excess flows through that pipe and out into the outlet here, and it goes into our sewer system. Now, we are very keen on the water quality of this system because the fish produce wastes, and these wastes are very toxic to the fish, mostly ammonia. So we also have a test system for testing ammonia. We also test the dissolved oxygen, and we also test some other chemicals in the water. We also use an equipment to do chemical analysis for alkalinity, that is hardness of the water. For us, we need that hardness for fish to grow well. And this system, we are expected to produce some 3,000 fish per week in this system. But when it is fully operational, we intend to produce something like 5 million fingerlings per year to give to farmers. I would like now, Ken, to show you how some of these measurements are done, and we'll also explain the machine that we use to do these measurements.
Thank you very much, Prof. Welcome, I'm Ken Rono, fish surgery technician. Maybe I can demonstrate how to measure some water parameters, dissolved oxygen and temperature. So you dip it inside. So you jack the first one will be the dissolved oxygen. So it should be at least 3 milligrams per liter to 5 milligrams per liter. So if it is below, you top up the fresh water, and then you also release the water through that outlet. So the second one is the temperature. The temperature you can also read. I think you can read from there. I think it's 24 point something. So it means it is within the optimal range for the Nile tilapia. I also have a machine for measuring ammonia level, which is the critical in aquaculture. So these are the test tube. You put a 5 ml, the same thing for this one also. Then we also have the reaction. We drop at least 2 drops. Then you can have then after dropping these 2 drops, you will have to close it. Then you will check now the readings for this one. So you will check, this one is the control. There is no reagent for this one. So you will have to check the color. So if they are uniform, you will be now able to read the measurement for the ammonia level on your pond or on your culture systems. Maybe you can read together. I think it is something like, I think you can now, they are somewhat the same. So it is 0. So it means our ammonia level in this culture facility is okay for our Nile tilapia. Thank you. Maybe we can move to see the hatchery unit. These other tanks are for the brooders. We separate male and female. So we put male here and the female on this other side. And then after 2 weeks, we combine the two. Maybe I can demonstrate for you how to differentiate male and female. So this is our male. Our male tilapia. So they have three openings. If you can check inly, you can see three openings from here. And also for the species of Onyloticus, you can see the black strips. Yeah, if you are a farmer, you have to be keen on the certified fish hatchery in order for you to have the correct fingerlings. So this is a male. You can see this big. And also their tails is also somehow pinkish. We also have a female fish. Sorry. Yeah, so you can see this smaller than a male. So they have two openings. You can keenly see it on their genital papillae. So they have two openings. And also you can check on also the black strips. So we normally combine a male of 1 to 3 females when you are breeding. Yeah. So if you are doing a fish hatchery, you need to know all those ratios. So after now combining one male and three females, we now procure the eggs. After procuring the eggs, now we put on these hatching jacks. So these are the hatching jacks. So we incubate it here for at least 3 to 5 days. They will hatch. So the yolk sac fry will swim to this white rays. So after swimming to this one, you have also to leave for at least 2 days to assimilate the yolk sac. So at the yolk sac now we transfer to the rearing unit. So after transferring now to the rearing unit down there, it is where now we start giving the special diet for sexual fossil. So doing this hatching of the eggs, we will be sure now we will be having at least 100%, in fact, 100% pure males, as we have had males grow further than female. We also have some facilities for water quality, yeah, because the water quality is the critical thing. Even for the hatching of these eggs, we have to check the water quality, especially the ammonia. The ammonia, the pH. Yeah, we also use this one to measure the pH with a specific reagent. Yeah, and also the dissolved oxygen. The dissolved oxygen should be at least 5 milligrams per liter for the successful or 90% hatching of our fish eggs. We also have this equipment for the pH. So this one measured the pH. For the Nile tilapia, the pH level ranges from at least 6.5 to 9.5. Yeah, maybe I can give farmer to check on this. You can measure, you can tip it like this, and then check the temperature and the pH. Yeah. So we also have this reagent for measuring alkalinity, chlorine level, because chlorine level is also a critical. Chlorine level should be at least lower. Yeah. So these are the equipment for measuring our water quality for our success of both the debo size or our brooders and our fingerlings.
7.25.
So it means this within the range, the optimal range for the tilapia and even the catfish species. So for this hatching unit, for example, it can hatch to 30,000 hatchlings at once. So that one is 5,000, 5,000, 5,000, I think there are six. So 5,000 times six, it means it can give you hatchling of about 30 fries or the fingerlings. Yeah, so you can see this symbol, but it will give you a good output. So you can modify, yeah, instead of even importing. You can use the local material, because even I think for the chicken, yeah.
So by the time you want to mix the female and male,
How do you know the size? This size is enough for a female to give a man?
There should be at least 200 to 500 grams. Yeah, and also you have to check if they are ready to spawn. Yeah, you have to try to strip their eggs, you check. And also even the color of the genital papillae of their organs, you can also, you will be able to look or to check if they are ready to spawn.
He told us that three females can be given just a male. So I was asking myself, why is it that way?
We have talked about the energy required to serve those three females is adequate or sufficient. It can also be reduced even to one female, but in terms of the economical aspect. If one male can serve three females, why don't you put maybe even two males to serve three females? Yeah, but the major key is the energy required for one male that can able to serve three females.
I want to add something on this. Now, why do we use fish that is 200 to 500 grams, or even less? Imagine somebody like me who is going to 70, 80 years. I eat one whole chicken every day. What value will it make by weight? Nothing. So the moment you have fish that is 500 grams and you keep on feeding it, it is not growing, it is using your feed costs money, but you're not getting production from it. So we prefer fish between 200 to 350 grams for breeding. Once they're big, like that one, we just sell it for food. That's the reason why we use.
You explained back there how whatever you do to make the fish to be a male, not even a female. Which procedure or which chemical are you using to make them all male?
We are not using chemical, but we are using the hormone from the fish. Yeah, so that hormone are formulated with diet. So they are formulated with certain concentration. Then that we call it methyl testosterone hormone. Then we feed for those 21 days. Yeah, so it is not an harmful chemical. We can also manipulate our temperatures to at least 37. Then we shock now the hatchlings of the yolk sacs. The yolk sac. So after shocking for those 10 days, we'll also be sure the young ones will be at least 99 to 100%. Because when these hatchlings have the yolk sac, it means they are neither male nor female. It means they have not developed their sexual organ. That is why now we are keen on that specific time. After yolk sac, then we administer the diet or we induce a temperature shock.
How long will male fish stay together with these three females for the reproduction?
At least 2 weeks. So after 2 weeks, we procure their mouth brooders. So we remove the eggs from their mouths. Then those eggs from their mouth, we bring them to this hatching unit. Then after, let's say, 3 to 10 days, we'll be able now to get the hatchings after the yolk sac stage.
Thank you very much, our farmers. I think we are very much keen on working with you. And I believe that you have challenges of getting your fingerlings. You have to go all the way to Kindu Bay, to Sangoro, or to those other far places. But I believe with your support and with the cooperation, we'll be able to serve you because you are our stakeholders. We are very happy that you have made your time to come and visit us. And we would like to get your contact so that we inform you as we develop the hatchery and as we are able to give you fingerlings, we'll be able to get in touch with you so that we can deliver or you can come and take your fingerlings. Thank you very much, and you are welcome again to use at any time for any other agricultural activity. Thank you very much.